It is 286. Just question. Find a general equation for the line, an equation for the plane that passes through the origin and is perpendicular to the line of the intersection. Got it. Cool. So, visually, I have a line that's at 3, or a plane that's at 3.
Yeah.
Z equals 3.
Yep.
I have a plane that runs on that equation, y equals x minus 2.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Okay. The line of intersection is the actual y equals x minus 2, right?
Sort of, yeah. I mean, y equals x minus 2 is technically the equation of a plane
right.
in space. But, yeah. So yeah, so you'd have to kind of like parameterize the line.
But, so here's my question.
Uh-huh.
Because of this, the parameters they gave us, right? Z equaling something and x equaling something.
Uh-huh.
If I just find a line that's perpendicular to the y equals x minus 2 that runs through the origin.
Y equals what?
Y equals x minus 2.
Okay. Y equals x. Okay, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So here, right?
Mm-hmm.
This line perpendicular to the origin and make that a plane. So basically what I'm saying is that I have y equals negative x because it goes through the origin and it intersects at a 90 degree angle perpendicular and anything on that plane up and down is going to hit both. See what I'm saying?
So what you have is an x, a y, and a z.
Check.
And you're noting that if z equals 3, that's really the equation of a plane.
Right.
It's parallel to the xy plane. Right?
3 above it, yeah.
3 steps above. And, but we also have this line.
Not a plane.
In the xy plane, but it's really a plane.
It's right.
Perpendicular to the xy plane. Given by what? Y equals what again?
Y equals x minus 2.
X minus 2. That means it hits the y axis over here. Negative 2.
Right.
And comes through here at positive 2, right? Something like this?
Yes.
So you can imagine.
Here's I tried to draw this like 1,000 times. I was like,
yeah.
It's tricky. I had it the other way, leaning the other way. I was like, okay, yeah, cool.
It's a tricky one to draw. So, but now I can see that the line of
intersection
right. between these two. Right, especially once I can see that, let's see here. I can see that, you know, part of this plane is in the first octant.
Right.
Part of this plane is showing up behind the x and z plane.
Right.
So let's see here, if I could kind of make that distinction. It's about right there, I guess. But now I can see that that this horizontal plane and this vertical plane are gonna intersect right along use a black for this intersection. So I think it's going to be about right here.
Right.
You know what I mean? I can extend it out. So you can imagine this line is actually in the blue plane. So every single point in the line is 3 steps above the xy plane.
Exactly.
But it's also in this red plane. Which means it's also kind of piercing through, part of it is in the first octant, but part of it's piercing through that octant over there and even into the octant behind the YZ plane.
Right.
So, okay, we're getting a good idea. And then there was the origin. So we're trying to find the equation of a plane that's perpendicular to this line.
Exactly.
And contains the origin, right?
Passes through
the origin. Yeah. And it's kind of a challenge to draw. Okay.
So, because now that I look at it, y equals 3 minus x.
Mm-hmm.
No. So, how do you know the z? But anyways, okay. So, let's just say, let me, this is So y plus x plus 3 equals 0, minus 3 equals 0. It says it wants a plane.
So I think for problems like this, it's advisable to work backwards.
Okay.
Right? I think it's a good idea to work backwards. In other words, what are we trying to find?
Yeah, that's one.
Right?
Right.
Yeah, so that's what I mean to work backwards. Okay, what's my goal here? I'm trying to find the equation of a plane.
Right.
So we need to find equation of a plane. And so the second, that means that the second to last step to our solution is to find the things that are necessary to write the equation of a plane.
Okay.
You need two things to write the equation of a plane. What do you need?
So yeah. I'm sorry, go ahead.
But yeah, like, you know, one thing to derive, you know, as you rehash your notes from last week, we talked about lines and planes. That's pretty much it.
Right.
And in both cases, you need two things to write the equation of a line or the equation of a plane.
Yeah, you need point of intersection?
Well, intersection is like, presupposes that you have two things that can intersect.
Right.
If it's just a plane, if all that exists is a plane, if I want to write the equation of a plane, right? Mm-hmm. I need two things. I need a point in the plane.
Okay, yeah. I was going to say coordinate next, but okay.
Sure, yeah. And?
Hold on. A line containing in the direction. I don't know what plane is on. I mean, mm-hmm. If I need a point for that plane, for that Z plane, right?
Yeah.
So I know everything that has X, Y, and 3 mm-hmm. is on that plane.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know.
And we're not going to be using the things I'm describing here. It's not going to be used on this plane nor on that plane.
Right,
because we already have the equation of a plane, so it's right there and there.
Right.
What I'm trying to find is the equation of a plane that I haven't even drawn yet, and I'm kind of challenge. It's kind of challenging to draw. I guess okay, I'll take a stab at it. It looks like it would, because it's kind of like I'm imagining like this plane right here and this plane right here, so the intersection is going to be along here, so the plane would have to be kind of coming like this, I think.
Right.
So it's going to be some sort of a plane like that, some sort of a plane that's going to. It never actually enters in to the x to the first octant. It's actually going to pass through here, something like that.
So orientation?
Hmm?
An orientation what we need?
Yeah, the orientation. And the way we describe orientation
is
with a normal vector.
Oh, no. Oh, okay, yeah, okay, gotcha. Yeah, normal vector. And that is something that's orthogonal.
Yeah, orthogonal.
Orthogonal.
But yeah, so you know, working backwards, it kind of helps you to kind of like come up with a game plan.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I need to find the equation of a plane. If I have any hope of doing so, I need to do these two things. Once I've accomplished these two things, I'm basically done.
Right.
I haven't written it down, but you have it in your notes. A way to take these two things here once you find them.
Yeah, so to make the cross product equal to 0.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. In fact, this one, I didn't know it's actually the dot product. Right? Because the picture that I have in mind when I do these, when you write the equation of a plane?
Yeah, it's dot product.
Right? Yeah, it's a set of all points for which these is magnitudes.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
So therefore, dot product. And, point in the plane, normal vector to the plane. One of these is already done.
Actually, halfway done.
Yeah. We have a point in the plane, namely that one.
But then Okay, it would have to cut. Yeah. And that's the only way you could slice. Yeah, that's the only way you could slice it to. Mm-hmm. Okay, pull home.
What I need now is a vector that's normal to that plane.
Okay.
Right. Where are we going to get to the vector such as that one?
Y equals x minus 2.
But that's not a vector.
Yeah, okay, so
it is going to come from there. We're going to get a vector from there.
Right, so where to start? Like, I would start at...
I would keep working backwards.
Right, okay.
Right? Do you see anywhere in this picture where such a vector is already drawn?
Yes.
Where?
Such a vector. Hold on.
That is to say, a normal vector.
A normal vector.
I've attempted to draw
the
plane.
Hold on, hold on. Continue saying what you were saying, sir.
You drew the plane. I've drawn the plane.
Yes.
I've drawn this line.
Yes.
This line which is perpendicular to the plane.
Roger.
And, you know, it's a... yeah, I don't know. Where does it actually pierce? It looks like it actually pierces the... it's actually kind of hard to tell where that line actually meets the, in the plane. Maybe it meets the plane, I'm going to say, probably like around here. I'm probably actually behind a little bit.
-1, -1, -1, 3?
Could be.
Oh. I mean, because that point is... it's literally... because the way I did it is I had x, y, 2. Like I said,
okay.
The...
okay. I'm starting to see where you're coming from now. Yeah, you're thinking of something different from what I'm thinking of. But I think that'll work.
Okay.
I think that'll work. You're literally trying to find the coordinates of these points.
Yes.
If you can find just three points in the plane, mm-hmm. right? Then I think you could use those 3 points to find the normal vector. Okay, yeah, that's a good idea.
Okay.
So, and I think you said, so I think you're, I want to take it a step before what you said.
Okay.
Because I think in order to know that, you'd have to know where, you know, like, I think you can see that there's a point right here. Would have to know. Yeah, I guess if it's going to be perpendicular, and since the slope of this line in the xy plane is 1, the slope of this line would have to be -1.
Exactly. Cool.
And so this would have to be at +1, -1, 0?
Yes, if it's not.
And this point up here would clearly be, because it's in the where the line intersects, because it's in the plane where z equals 3, that would be at -1, -1, 3.
Right.
And then, of course, we have this point over here. That's the easiest of the three, at 0, 0, 0. Nice. So you have 3 points in the plane.
Right.
And from those 3 points, maybe you could find a normal vector.
Right.
Nice. Yeah, that'll work. That's not what I had in mind, but that'll work.
Okay.
How would you finish it off from there? How do you use those 3 points to find a normal vector?
So, x minus x sub 9, comma y minus y sub 9. Comma z minus y z sub 9 times abc.
Mm.
So,
right.
Equation of plane a times quantity of a. Okay, so.
Right, so in order to use that formula,
yeah,
you need to know the normal vector. Once you know what the normal vector is, you're going to use that a, b, and c in the formula for the plane.
But if the normal vector, if I have. I'm trying to find the line normal to y equals x minus 2.
Mm-hmm.
So perpendicular and inverse perpendicular. We did it in pre-calculus.
Mm-hmm.
It was, yeah, inverse and perpendicular. X. Negative X. Yeah. I know it's negative. It's negative X. The equation of line I would use would be, but where am I missing?
I think you're still thinking in terms of
two dimensions.
In terms of, you're thinking in three dimensions, but you're still thinking in terms of coordinates.
Right.
And part of the goal in this section is you're trying to kind of like retrain your mind to think instead of thinking in terms of coordinates, to think in terms of vectors.
Okay.
It opens the door to other insights and other ways of solving problems. Right.
Okay. So I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
But then, so would it not be the bottom one, the 1, negative 1, 0,
mm-hmm.
as a vector, being the ABC?
Oh, well, as a vector, that would be a vector that begins here at the origin and ends there.
Right.
That's a vector that's in, yeah, that's in the plane that you're looking for.
Right.
So that means that it's not normal to the plane. It's actually in the plane.
So I'm looking for normal.
If this is the plane we're looking for,
right,
then what we're looking for is a normal vector to the plane. This vector right here is actually in the plane.
X, Y, plane when X is 0. X, Y, plane with the vector. Is that the dot product yet?
Of what?
I still got to find an ABC.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm stuck.
Well, to think of this in terms of vectors, this is what, let me show you what I mean. So like, if you think in terms of coordinates, you're looking at all these points, trying
right.
to make sense out of it, trying to find a vector, this is a mess of a picture to look at. When you think about it in terms of vectors, you don't need all these coordinates, right?
Right.
You don't even need numbers at all.
Right.
Right? I can look at this picture, and I just know that once you have three points in the plane, then I can just subtract two points to get a vector, which is what you did.
Right.
I can pick another pair of points and get another vector like this one.
Then I can cross product them to get the normal vector.
Exactly.
Okay, I'm sorry.
So once you have two vectors that are in the plane, you can take the cross product to find the vector that's normal to the plane.
Okay.
Yeah. But you see how I think the art, by thinking in terms of vectors, the picture was really cleaned up a lot.
Right, yeah.
It's a lot easier to see what's going on here than it is to see what's going on there.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah. Well, let me just do cross with 1, negative 1, 3.
Mm-hmm.
I, J, K. Negative 3 minus 0? 3 minus 0? Minus J 3 minus 0 plus K negative 3 minus 0. Sorry. Three, negative three, comma,
That's crazy.
Negative 3.
Yeah, I guess it depends. Which one did you put first?
1, -1, 0.
One, okay, right there. So and you then, put that in the second row?
Yes.
Okay.
And then that, but then, yeah.
Okay, so
yeah,
same way.
-3. So, but hold on, so the last one though, K. -1, -1
mm-hmm.
is
+1, 0.
Zero. And then you took out the 3 though?
Yeah, because I don't really care how long the vector is. I just need the direction.
Okay.
It just needs to be a normal vector. It could be a long normal vector. It could be a short normal vector. I don't care.
Because it's infinite amount of possibilities.
Sure.
I just need the unit one. Okay. So
yeah.
1, 1, 0. What if 1, 1. Okay, yeah, that is that one. Okay, yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But so then, but then my question is, x -2 is
mm-hmm.
normal to that line too.
x -2 isn't a vector. It's a plane.
Okay, what if I? Yeah, what you saying? I got it. Cool. So now that 1, 1, 0 times, or dot.
Mm-hmm. So what I just erased this A, B, C. I just wrote, this is the direction vector I'm interested in. I left off the 3. I don't need the -3. The direction is adequate.
Okay. Yep. Gotcha. Cool.
Yeah. So basically, once you have these two things, you're home free.
Right.
Right. All you got to do is just put the pieces together. Well, that's right. This is a homework question.
Yeah. But then that, like I said, that's the easy part because it's x -x0
mm-hmm.
a times x. But then if you use 0, 0, 0.
Yeah.
Then it just becomes
mm-hmm.
Okay. So, okay. Then the ABC. So nah, that can't be because it doesn't have any letters.
Mm-hmm.
Z. I'm over here crazy. Okay. So x -1. No, x -0. So x. Plus y plus k z equals 0?
Well, it's.
No. X plus y equals 0.
Is a.
A. Which is 1. Yeah, 1.
Times x minus x naught.
0. Yeah, so that's x plus b1 x plus y, but then the last one, 0.
0 times z minus 0, technically.
Right. So you want the, like that, or do you want it reduced?
No, you can reduce it.
So x plus y equals 0.
There you go.
I said it was
Z. Oh, is that what you said?
That is literally.
I thought I heard a Z.
And then, legitimately, what I had for my answer was y equals negative x.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I guess you were right then. But actually, you know, you were actually like really close to a quicker solution.
Okay, I'm sorry. Cool.
You said something along the way that I thought was pretty interesting.
Okay.
what you said was that this vector right here, if I heard you right, I think you said that vector was in this plane.
Right, or parallel.
Yeah.
Yeah, parallel.
It's in, it's literally in the plane because it's normal.
Right.
Right. And it, but it's also, you didn't say this, but it's also in this blue plane.
Right.
Right? So the vector that you just found is actually in this plane and in that plane. Wait, hold on. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That means it's in the intersection.
Okay.
Right? And at this point of intersection, see, because you're given two planes, in the same way that if I have a point and a normal vector, I can write the equation of a plane.
Right.
It's a two-way street. If I have a plane, I can extract any point from the plane and a normal vector from the plane.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so for example, like if you look at this right here, if I was to rewrite it like this as, you know, x minus 2 times 1 plus 1 times y minus 0 plus 0 times z minus 0 equals 0, for example, I can see that the point 2, 0, 0 is a point in the plane.
Right.
But I can also see, more importantly, that 1, 1, 0 is a vector that goes in the, that's normal to this red plane. This is a normal vector to the red plane.
Right.
And if I was to draw it at this point right here, it would be going like this. Right? And likewise, you could think of this z as like being 0 times x minus 0 plus 0 times y minus 0 plus z minus 3 times 1,
right?
0. From that, I can clearly see that we have a normal vector of, well, if it was a horizontal line, I guess it would be pretty obvious if this is the normal. So maybe I didn't have to think that hard.
Right.
But this, since this vector is normal to the red plane, and that vector is normal to the blue plane if you extend it out further.
Okay, right.
Then the direction of that line would be the cross product of those two vectors.
Right. Oh, right, right. Cool.
So what you did is you constructed three points. I'm saying you could have also taken the extracted the normal vectors, take the cross product of those, and that would give you a vector going in this direction.
Right.
And you can use that as the normal vector to the plane that we're trying to find. You see? And I think we get the same answer. Even though they look quite different, like in this case, I'm using 1, 1, 0 crossed with 0, 0, 1. Actually, this one has the advantage of being computationally easier.
Yeah.
Just because
it
has zeros, right? I, J, K, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And in this case, you can see how you get 1 minus 0. You get 1 minus 0, but it's a negative. Wait, hold on. 1 minus 0, yeah, that's right. And then 0 minus 0. Interesting.
No, no, yeah, you, your red arrow is on the wrong plane, I'm sorry.
Oh.
It should have been the X. No, no, that is the normal. You did.
Oh. Oh, you know what happens? I brought this over, the white over right here, so this should be a negative 1.
Right.
Like that.
And then that makes it, yeah.
That makes this a negative 1. That makes this a negative 1. So now we have a negative 1 minus 0. And then this is still the same. That's 1 minus 0, but it's the opposite because it's the second coordinate. And then 0 minus 0. And that's the same thing as negative 1.
Factor it out, then.
Same difference.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So interesting. These are interesting problems. You know, they really challenge you to kind of like think spatially.
Yeah.
Which we don't get many opportunities to do that unless, like, I don't know, you're a pilot or something like that. I don't know.
Rocket scientist.
Most of us are confined to the surface of the Earth.
Right.
Where everything is more or less two-dimensional. But yeah.
Cool. All
right, yeah.
Man, I had that answer.
Yeah, well, so you got it. You got it. One way or another, but I think this is like a great problem, even if you get the right answer, to really consider other ways of looking at it.
Yeah. Right.
And I like to, I think when I was taking this class, I must have had a lot of time on my hands, but I liked going, once I saw like a different way of looking at it,
mm-hmm.
was to redo some of the problems I had already done.
Okay.
But to redo them from that perspective.
Right.
You know? Because I was trying really hard to kind of force myself to think in this different way, you know? Whenever I see like this genius way of thinking, I want to like assimilate it into my thinking, you know? That's the best way I know what to do, you know?
Go back there.
Yeah.